Hey, this is Sasha. Thanks for joining me in today's video. And what I want to share with you today is how much web hosting do you really need when it comes to a hosting package? So we're going to answer this question and tackle it a little bit more in detail. So stay tuned. Okay, so if you're building a website, you want to have a website, you want to have an online presence, you need web hosting. So the question is what is web hosting? So web hosting, if you don't know what web hosting is, it's basically a service where you rent computer power to make your website accessible to everyone on the World Wide Web. Now, there's different types of plans that you could go with when it comes to web hosting. So if you're looking at web hosting plans already, you might have noticed that there's probably shared hosting, VPS, virtual private hosting, and even a dedicated server space that you could go ahead and go with. Now, they all are a little bit different. So think of it like in tiers. You have shared hosting is kind of the baby step. The VPS is a little bit higher, and the dedicated is even more so, a little bit more premium. And if you're looking for a shared hosting, it's basically what happens is your website is on a network where you're sharing server space with many other individuals. So think of it like a computer. It's holding your website on there. And anytime somebody wants to access that website, that computer sends out the signal, the data, the information to someone else to pop it up. And if you're sharing that space, it's one computer might have 2,000 or 4,000 websites. Now, as you go up in tiers and in space, you get to VPS, where you're sharing the space, but it might be with maybe just 7 different individuals. And each one of those individuals may have 5 or so websites. So at least you have a little bit more control when it comes to your web hosting. There's not just a ton of people on one network or one computer. And this is really good because think of it this way. If you had your website with 2,000 other individuals, all of a sudden, if one individual compromised the server got hacked, they weren't protecting their files, your website could also be compromised because now all of a sudden there's vulnerabilities that are in play there. So this is where going to a VPS is much more comforting. Not only do your website has a little bit more power behind it because it has more resources to use for that computer, because everybody that comes and hits your website takes a little bit of usage from that computer power. And if you got 2,000 website hits, it may not use a lot of power, but let's say you have 50 million website visitors coming to your website. Well, you need a computer that's more powerful, or you need to daisy chain and link computers together to create a really powerful network of computers. And that's what Facebook and Google does. It's not just on one computer where they're running a whole Google operation. It's server farms running the Google empire, because all these people are just coming and hitting Google, and it just takes up a lot of server space and resources. And then when you get beyond that, when you go to a higher level, dedicated hosting is really ultimately your own controlled hosting, where you can control the server and everything that's on it. And anything that really goes wrong with the server beyond the hardware part is really up to you. Now, they have managed and unmanaged, where other companies can manage those things for you. But when you're looking at really just who's on that account, it's really only you and your website. Now, you could put one website on there. If you have a really powerful website, a lot of hits, a lot of traffic, you might need one website on one dedicated hosting plan. But if you have, let's say, a couple of baby sites, one or two intermediate sites, and maybe one really premium or good website that's getting a lot of traffic, well, in that case, you might be able to deal with also just a nice dedicated server, and you could still house that and it would still work just fine, because dedicated hosting really should be able to handle the power of quite a lot of traffic and a lot of space and resources. So let's check some of these things out and kind of look into them a little bit more. If you go to our website at backstageincome.com, you can really just go ahead and go to the resources section. And here we have a few hosting partners and things you could check out that are very useful, beneficial, and they've been around for quite a while. Now, most of them, what they'll have, if you look at Bluehost and you go into hosting, what you can see is a lot of them will say shared, VPS, and dedicated. So if you look at these plans, let's just go to shared hosting right here. You can see that what's happening here is your basic plan is $3.95, and you pretty much can only put one website on there. Now, they kind of limited on their end. You might be able to put two really simple websites on there, but because of their infrastructure, they just want one website on there. If you go with Plus, which is a little bit more feature, it says unlimited websites, but ultimately it's really not unlimited. You know, there's always server space that's going to cloud some things, unlimited SSD storage. So, I mean, you probably can't put on 10 million pictures, unmetered bandwidth. There's no such thing. What you really have to understand is that as you continue to go up in these plans, it's going to continue to, you're going to continue to evolve simply because what's going to happen is you're going to outgrow these, the space on there, because even though it might say unlimited, eventually things start to operate a little bit more slowly, and those kinds of things. So there's really no such thing as unlimited when it comes to hosting. There's always a limit. They're just going to have to upgrade you your plan. And that usually means that you're all of a sudden getting more hits, more traffic. And then if you look at here is the VPS kind of hosting. Again, you get kind of two cores, 30 gigabytes SSD storage, and 2 gigabytes of RAM. Because why would I pay $20 for 30 gigs of SSD storage when I could get the unlimited for $4.95? You see my point? So ultimately, this gives you more power. You got 1 terabyte of bandwidth, 1 IP address, and so on and so forth. So you could see what happens is the more hits, the more traffic, the more space that you need, ultimately it gets more expensive and more pricey. And Bluehost, I find, usually caters towards people just getting started. There are some more premium companies out there. So you could see they do also have dedicated items. But remember, if everybody's moving over to Bluehost, or if you're seeing a lot of recommendations for one thing, it might not be the best place to go to for your hosting. And I say that because think of it like if everybody's going to eat at the same restaurant at the same exact time. You might be waiting in line for 2 to 3 hours, and that's not necessarily a good thing. So if everybody's going to the same company for hosting, then all of a sudden what's going to happen is your servers are going to get clogged. Their resources, their human resources on managing those servers are also a problem, because there's just not enough time in the day if a part fails to change those things out. So that's what I want you to think about as you choose hosting. But it doesn't matter in a sense who exactly you go with. Just go with a general company that seems to be reliable. And sometimes as you have 2 or 3 websites, you might go ahead with 2 or 3 different hosts to split up the risk, because if one site goes down, at least the other is operating. And that's one of the things that I typically do, is I have multiple hosts with multiple companies. Sometimes you'll have starter plans. You can see here's HostGator, here's one site, 100,000 visitors a month, 2 sites, 200,000 visitors, and 3 sites, 500,000 visitors per month. You could also go ahead and do VPS here, and there's also dedicated. Same kind of concept applies here. This one is a little bit more premium. As you can see, you got 8 cores, whereas Bluehost didn't even have that. So sometimes if you really want some power, some of these other companies, and like Liquid Web, can really go ahead and go beyond just the basic limits. And you'll see that as you go ahead and start comparing more and more plans, there's just so many things out there. Let's say if you're an agency, right here, meaning you're holding a lot of websites. There's just so many different things that you could do. Managed WordPress, managed WooCommerce, VPS, dedicated. So there's a ton of different things out there when it comes to hosting. But if you're brand new, if you're just getting started, getting just a basic solution for about $5 to $7 a month should get you started. And as you continue to get more website hits, traffic, and continue to evolve your website, you'll probably have to upgrade plans to something a little more advanced. It could be more of a VPS, and then later to a dedicated, just depending on how powerful and big your website gets. Anyways, I hope this video was helpful and insightful. Feel free to check out the Backstage Income website, where you can download a lot of different freebies there, guides. And remember to hit subscribe here on YouTube, or join the mailing list by clicking the link over here. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.